If ever a wake-up call seemed to come too soon, this would be the one. At 8 a.m. Sunday, 65 soldiers marched into a packed house to say one final proper goodbye.
Good morning and welcome to Camp Dodge for the send-off ceremony of Charlie Troop 113th Cav.
We didn't sleep, I know me and Brandon really didn't sleep at all last night.
Brandon Salazar is about to leave his fiancée Abby and their son Aiden. The baby's 9 months old, dad's on active duty, the next 18.
Right now my biggest concern is making sure this little guy knows exactly what his daddy's doing over there and remembers exactly what he is when he comes back.
Aiden's dad has never been to war before.
I thought it would be all right, but it's getting harder and harder each minute I'm here.
For 20 minutes, they stand at attention as dignitaries offer praise. A chaplain extends a prayer.
The people say, amen.
And as soon as it began, the goodbye is nearly over. A real wake-up call that seemed a little to them to come too soon.
It's kind of getting really sad and down to the wire, so.
The sooner home, the better, I guess, you know? So now we are entering a different stage, and now it's kind of a cowboy up, and you get it done and wait for him to get home.
Emily Givens, KCCI News Channel 8.
In 2005, we introduced you to Brandon Salazar saying goodbye to his fiancée Abby and his son Aiden as he headed to Iraq. 18 months later, we caught up with Abby again, with baby Aiden, now a toddler, just minutes away from Brandon's return.
I've been without my fiancé for almost a year and a half, so we're excited to get him home. We're excited to start living as a normal family, two-parent family, so we're excited, definitely.
It's a grand entrance for the 113th Cavalry.
Good evening. Welcome to the homecoming ceremony for the 113th Cavalry, Iowa Army National Guard.
While in Iraq, this unit provided security for more than 3,000 missions. They've brought home with them more than 10 Purple Hearts and 20 Bronze Medal Stars. What they didn't bring home is memorialized at the front of the stage. Sergeant Dan Sesker died in Iraq on April 6, 2006.
God bless Sergeant Sesker for the sacrifice he made. He will never be forgotten.
Finally, the moment 18 months in the making, Brandon Salazar is reunited with his family.
It feels great. We went over there, we accomplished our mission, we came back. I think after what happened to Dan Sesker, we all came together and realized we need to get our mission done and get back home to our families.
Wonderful, wonderful, yep. Yeah, so we're gonna go enjoy our next couple days and